Oh, this is gonna be a really tough video. This doesn't look any better. Hey guys, so today is going to be a sit down sound off Sunday, but I don't think it's gonna go up on a Sunday. There's a lot to go over. This is gonna be a difficult video because I feel like I'm gonna be all over the place. I have a lot to talk about. If you guys are new to my channel, I was gonna say my name is Teresa Hurado. And also, if you're new to my channel, this is the first video you're watching, it's about to get real personal. So we're about to know each other really well after this. Trying to at least look a little decent. Whatever. That's as good as we're gonna get. But yeah, so a sit down sound off Sunday is basically a chit chatty get ready with me, and we just talk about a whole bunch of stuff while I do my makeup. If you guys are interested in hearing a lot of stuff about what's been going on and what's happening and happened and all that stuff, then keep watching. All right, I'm gonna try my best to not let my brain get in the way of this video because that's what has been just happening to me the past few months. I don't know what you would call it, but just very stunted. For instance, right now, all I can think about is how there's so many cars outside because of course I waited, well not waited, but I had to do other stuff. And so when I'm filming this, it's rush hour. So there's so many cars outside making a whole bunch of noise. And that bothers me. Huge thing is time management lately for me. I don't know, I've never been good at time management, but lately it just seems like it's gotten way worse. If you see little pieces of stuff on my face, it's because I just waxed also. I have a video coming out about that. I'm gonna be using this Tarte High Tides and Good Vibes palette. This thing is amazing. Look at it. You see how it has this little, like, I don't know what you call it. Probably something that you don't want to break open, but it has some kind of liquid inside of it. And I think that's pretty cool. So there is a 0% chance that this video isn't going to be a bunch of rambling because that's the way my brain is right now. I feel like I haven't got stuff together in months. I don't know the best analogy, but I feel like a ball in a ping pong machine. And I just keep going bounced around and I'm just bouncing through and I can never get a footing on anything, nor do I feel like I'm ever really accomplishing much. I just feel like life's just taking me and throwing me everywhere. And not a good feeling, really not a good feeling. Oh, I don't even know where to start. If you guys know, this is gonna be like super, super difficult to talk about. Just dive right in. If you guys know what had gone on in the past, well, in January, I had lost my father, and showing emotion, I hate it. I absolutely hate it. Everyone at the funeral probably thinks I'm a sociopath because I try my hardest not to show any emotion to people. I don't like crying in front of people. Like only a couple people can I do that in front of. I don't like crying in front of people. I don't like letting my guard down. I don't ever want to appear not in control. It's a huge thing with me, so that's also a little bit of a difficult part. I'm one of those people that definitely makes inappropriate jokes. Bruce is the same way, so we've been keeping each other company with some inappropriate jokes, but I definitely don't handle that kind of stuff very well. So again, like I said, when I had one other serious video, I don't really talk too serious, but I had one where I was talking about Bruce and I's relationship. I said, if I come off cold or unfeeling, it's not like I actually feel that way. It's just a wall that I put up, and like, I don't mean to do it, but I do. And so sometimes it comes off like I don't have feelings, but I do. So that whole situation, I definitely thought I was going to not have as hard of a time as I am. I definitely thought that it was going to be something that, I mean, everyone goes through it, right? Like everyone eventually will go through that kind of thing. So I figured it would just be something, okay, you know, handle it head on, conquer it. And I thought I did. Kind of. I mean, there was a whole process, obviously, if you guys have ever gone through something like that. There's a process that happens right away that you have to do, like, funeral and all that kind of stuff. So that's one part of grieving where I guess you just kind of check that part off. But then afterwards is, like, kind of the weird part, I guess. I don't know. Like, I still, and this is super glossed over, I'm not going to go into details. I'm not going to talk real in-depth about it. Maybe someday I'll do a video talking more in-depth, but just not right now. I feel like it's almost, I wouldn't want to try and capitalize on that. I think it'd just be odd. But anyway, I just don't really understand the grieving process and exactly how you're supposed to grieve. Like some people say, like, let yourself be sad and all this stuff. But for me, it's the hardest part of when I'm having a day, like a normal day. Nowhere in that day do I say, you know what I should do right now? I'm gonna stop what I'm doing. I'm gonna stop filming a video. I'm gonna stop thinking of ideas. I'm just going to cry. Like, you don't do that. I don't know. I guess I've been having a difficult time figuring out when exactly is this supposed to take place. And I definitely feel like it's been coming out in other ways. I've just been very unmotivated, very I mean, for a while, I just really didn't want to get out of bed. It was weird because it wasn't a feeling of, wow, this thing is making me so sad that I cannot get out of bed. It was just feeling just unmotivated. I didn't want to do anything. Caffeine wasn't helping. I just wanted to sit in bed and just watch TV, just easy stuff. I didn't want to actually put out any effort. So that was one of the reasons why my videos have been super scarce. I just haven't been feeling very wanting to do that much, which is terrible because all the algorithms will punish you so bad. Because if you don't consistently post on everything, they won't push your videos out, or in Instagram, they won't push your posts out to people. So it's really been a, I don't know what you call it, not double-edged sword, I don't know the analogy, but basically I'm not doing work, which is making me feel worse. And in turn, when I finally do get something out, it doesn't even get shared to everybody, which makes me feel even worse about my content. So that's been like kind of difficult to deal with. Obviously, like, that's just the nature of social media. I'm already just like regretting everything I just said. I feel, I don't know, I'm just such not a person that opens up a lot. I'm very quiet about stuff. All in high school, people thought I was the meanest person ever because I just don't, I'm a very quiet person. If something is upsetting me or if I'm not in a good mood, I just keep to myself. And that, I guess, comes off as kind of rude and standoffish, I guess, which is not my intent. That's kind of been standing in the way of me, you know, really throwing myself back into YouTube, because just essentially with everything that had gone on, I took a break, obviously. And then when I came back, I wanted to come back so strong, and you know, and it just didn't happen. I couldn't. And it was just a weird thing because in my head, I didn't feel like I was sad about particular stuff, but it was coming out in other ways. And I'm still trying to deal with that. I started exercising, which has been helping, but now all I want to do is be outside, exercise. I don't want to actually like do my job, which is like stupid. One of the hardest things, and I don't know, this is like out of the blue, but I just wanted to tell you guys. When I had got the news that my father was dying that particular day, I had just gotten, there's gonna be so many cuts in this, oh, I'm sorry. I had just gotten the Jeffree Star mystery box that I had paid $100-some for. I was very excited about it. I knew it was gonna be a hit. I knew that video was gonna do very, very well. I was one of the first people to receive it, so I knew my video was gonna go up right away. I was so excited. I ran to the post office, picked the box up that morning because I knew it was gonna be delivered that day. I did my makeup. I was ready. I was so excited to do that video. And the right before I filmed the video, I got a call from my mom. And I just, and I had gotten, she gave me the news. Nothing had happened yet, but it was going to. And I got to speak to him. And then, and there's a dog. I'm just gonna let that dog keep barking. But anyway, so I got off the phone and I'm just sitting there with my Jeffree box that I was just about to film. And I knew I was gonna have to film it because my channel greatly relies on these videos that I know are gonna be really big and that they'll reach out to new subscribers. And eventually when things had settled down, I would have been upset that I hadn't done that video. There was nothing I could do at that point. I couldn't fly and be anywhere in time. So all I could do was sit and wait. And I had to do it. I had to sit in that chair and just compose myself and swallow everything that had just happened and film this, the biggest, one of the biggest videos that I've ever had. I got 500,000 views in, I don't know, a week, and so many new subscribers. Maybe some of you guys from that video are watching this one right now. I don't know why my voice is cracking. That's not even the sad part, that's the happy part. But to just have to do your job, and you just have to. And that was just, I was really, really happy how the video turned out because I knew what I was going through when I filmed that and just had to talk about it. No, I love makeup, but you know, things are more important than the highlighter. Oh, I got a liquid frost. I got this. So it was just the weirdest situation that I've ever had to be in, and one of the hardest. So yeah, basically I'm pretty good at the whole swallow it and just deal with it later kind of thing, but dealing with it, like, this is my time to deal with it, I don't know how to do. So that's been a difficult part of filming and trying to get myself to film. I'm also a perfectionist and really hard on myself, and I'm not feeling my complete best. I knock something down on the hour, every hour. But if I don't feel like I can put out my best personality, I like to make jokes, I like to joke around and have fun. So if I'm not feeling like I can do that, I just think, what's the point of making a video? It's gonna be boring, stale, not funny, like I'm not into it. And then I end up putting out 2 videos a week when I want to put out 3, sometimes just 1 video a week. It's very irritating, and then the editing takes me forever too because I'm just being hard on myself. And I don't want a break. That's the thing that I feel like would be an easy, I'll just take a break. Like, I don't want a break because I wouldn't know what to do with a break. And you gotta make money, you gotta do your job. So that's the hard part, but I'm trying really hard. So I'm doing this video, I thought it'd be better to let you guys in. And a lot of times, like, my favorite YouTubers, I'll have no idea what they're going through, and then when I see their video, I'm like, oh my gosh, I had no idea, like, you were going through this. Like, people are not for a fault either. Like, you are self-centered. You have to be self-centered. You have to worry about yourself. So you're not thinking about your favorite person on YouTube. Oh, I wonder what they're going through. You're just not thinking that all the time. So when they actually bring it to light, you're able to see, oh, they're going through something. And honestly, that makes me feel better knowing that other people are going through stuff too. I really hope this makeup turns good. What am I doing? Yeah, basically just wanted to touch on that, not go too deep into it because I don't know, I don't like talking about too much, but just letting you know what's going on in my head. Let's try white. Maybe white will save this. This champagne beach color. Alright, let's put some eyeliner on and move on. We've been on these eyes forever. Oh my goodness, how long is this video gonna be? Alright, moving on to a much different subject. Let's talk about super stale tea, but someone had messaged me to talk about it when it wasn't stale. It was like hot at that point, but I haven't done one of these in a little bit. So I went to the Jordyn Woods Eyelore event when it was her first event after everything had come out. It was on TMZ. It was big news at that point. If you guys don't know the brand Eyelore, it is a lash company. This particular eyeliner that I'm putting on is really good, but I can't look up, or else it'll put a line here, so that's why I'm looking down. But Eyelore is an eyelash brand that I've actually loved for a while. I got my first pair, I think, at a CVS years ago. They did a bunch of YouTube collabs, so I've always been a fan of the brand, and I had gotten reached out to attend the event that they were having, I think 2 or 3 weeks before the event actually was gonna happen. And so I had confirmed my attendance. I was like, yes, I would love to go. And so that was weeks before anything ever came out. I had already said I was going to attend. I'm gonna wait until this feels very passive aggressive, but I'm looking at you. I wanna look at you, hold on. So then the news broke out, and you guys know what happened. People just immediately started sending Jordyn Woods, not even just hate, but literal, I don't even know the word for it, but it was more than just hate. So it picked up pretty well, and I wasn't sure if they were even gonna have the event. I thought they might cancel it because she might not want to have to speak and do any kind of public appearance, but the day of the event, they said it's still going on, and they were excited to see everyone. And I am a huge supporter of Eyelore. I don't really know Jordyn Woods too much. Like, I've heard of her before, but I really didn't know her that well. Her lashes looked nice though. And my whole thing was, because I had been asked a couple times on my DMs and or yelled at in my DMs about why I attended. And I attended for a couple reasons. Number one, being that I was not there. This was 2 days after news just broke out. Like, just broke out. Not after the red table or anything like that. It was just happening. So everything was super, super hearsay. Nobody knew what was going on. Everything was super rumored. And I just couldn't believe all the things people were saying to her without even knowing a thing. So we didn't really know what happened, first off. Second off, I love Eyelore. I went there to support them professionally because I think they put out amazing products. They're not expensive. The lashes are very affordable. So, you know, I didn't want to cut a tie with a brand before we even knew anything whatsoever. I just hate the fact that sometimes people will just pull someone down so much without knowing a thing. And I just kind of felt bad. She went there professionally, and I respected that. She stood up and she fulfilled her obligation. And I said in my, because I did a little statement on Instagram then afterwards, that when more things come to light, of course I'll make my own personal decision how I feel about her. But at that point, we knew nothing except for the fact that she was fulfilling a business obligation. She was very cordial. She didn't stay out for very long, obvious reasons. TMZ was all over the place. There was tons of paparazzi going into the event and all that stuff. But hey, she did fulfill her obligation. And then once I watched the red table, is that what it's called, the red table? Again, I don't know what's true, what's false, any of that stuff, but if what she said was true, that's absolutely despicable that she was getting so much hate for something that was forced upon her. It's so hard because you have both sides saying this happened, someone else saying this didn't happen, and everyone's of course gonna have their own opinions, but I'm just never gonna be that person to spew out hate towards somebody when I don't know the whole story. At that point of the event, we didn't know literally anything. Loving Their Lashes, what an experience that was. It wasn't very full. A lot of people, I guess, either didn't show up or were uninvited. I was watching a Snapchat of someone who was talking about the guest list and all that stuff. I don't know. It was all over TMZ. I will say the decorations were gorgeous. They had pineapples all over the place. You guys know I'm obsessed with pineapples, so I just thought I would touch on that a little bit, tell you guys my firsthand account of that. I actually didn't think about it being such a huge thing until I saw like the paparazzi and I was like, oh, this is gonna be in the news. Let's talk about the ABH PR list. That has been on my mind for the past couple weeks, and it's been a ride. It's been a ride. So if you guys aren't familiar with what's been going on, Anastasia Beverly Hills, Norvina, she has been talking about adding people to a PR list, and she was basically tweeting a lot about saying she's making this list of influencers, micro-influencers, that she's gonna send the PR packages to and just add them to the PR list. People were freaking out, including me, because that's awesome that a large brand is literally asking for micro-influencers. Micro-influencers get screwed over a lot. A lot. If you guys haven't seen that video, check that out. But it's hard out there for when you first start out. And so it was very cool of her to be saying that she wanted to work with smaller influencers, because a lot of brands just want to work with like the really big ones. It kind of started to create a little bit of an uproar. People were getting upset about seeing a lot of people retweeting their looks a lot, and that was annoying to some people, which I understand. That's the hard part, because you need to tweet out a lot to be noticed, so it's kind of a, you're gonna annoy people for a little bit, but at the same time, it's kind of what you gotta do. And there's also the part of them, are they benefiting from this? Is it almost like a publicity stunt kind of thing? And I think it is extremely smart, because even if it is a publicity stunt, it's helping so many people. So I thought that was great. I participated, have not gotten an email or anything yet, but what I did get, because I mean, that was like a long shot. It was a really, really big long shot, especially because she had tweeted out saying that she likes a lot of avant-garde looks, artsy kind of stuff, and I have not really dove that much into that kind of stuff. I usually do pretty wearable looks, like tutorial stuff. For this PR search, I actually did do a few art looks, but it was kind of like if she really liked those looks and she went to my Instagram to see all my other work like that, there wouldn't be that much. So it wasn't a surprise that I have not gotten an email. I mean, there's still time, but I don't think so. But I did get an email from Wet n Wild. I was freaking out. I was so, so excited because I guess they had seen one of the artsy looks. I've tagged them in a lot of stuff. I use their products quite often. And this art look that I did, it's like a rainbow face kind of look. I had used their paint palettes, and I'm pretty sure because they had messaged me literally the day after on Instagram, not like in YouTube or anything. So I think that was what had possibly caught their eye. So I was so excited, and I would not have gotten that if I hadn't at least participated in this PR search. So I was so excited, and I think it really pushed me outside my box, other people outside of their box. Thank you guys so much to everyone that retweeted, that liked any of my tweets. It was amazing seeing so many likes, so many reach. I've never gotten that many in my entire life. So I was just so happy that the last look, the Riviera look, took forever. So I was so happy that it was getting recognition, and honestly, that made it all worth it. Thank you guys so much for being here and watching this video, which is a super personal video. I don't know, like, I always think, who wants to listen to my stuff? Like, who would care what's going on in my life? But at the same time, there's a lot of people that I watch when they do these kind of personal videos, and I love hearing about it. So hopefully some of you guys are like that too, and that you enjoyed this video. How has your guys' life been going lately? I keep seeing on Twitter that Mercury retrograde or something retrograde, the reason that things are going kind of crazy, but I don't know if I quite believe in astrology yet. My sign is, I don't know, it just doesn't fit me. I'm an Aries, but I'm not fiery or athletic or adventurous or anything like that, so I don't know. My moon sign is also Aries too. Like, there's a sun and a moon. They're all Aries. I don't know how that works. I'm the most meek person ever, but I don't know. Has everyone else's life been going kind of crazy because of the Mercury retrograde? That's what they say. This is the finished look. I'm not really sure how I feel about it. It was, I don't even know, a culmination of emotion, I guess. Usually in these sit down and sound off Sundays, I go through the comments from the last video, but the last video was about 2.5 months ago or something like that. So I'm not doing that in this video, but I'll hope to do it in the future. I don't know if I'm gonna regularly do these every week. Would it be really weird to have a sit down sound off Sunday on a various day of every couple weeks? It's just so hard to pin down on a certain thing, but that's just me. I need to get my stuff together. Hopefully we can get that working again, but until then, these might be sporadic, but thank you guys so much for watching. If you have not subscribed and you're still here, why? Thank you so much, but I can't imagine still watching me right now, but if you are, definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be alerted when I put out a new video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. It looks better without the robe. Why didn't I film the outro with this?